I made a note here about what inspiration is. You see it on your sheet? Very important note. That the Bible is verbally and plenarily inspired. Now, back 50 years ago, you didn't have to make that designation. You just said you held to the inspired Word of God. And the more liberal area of the church would say this, well, the idea is inspired, the concepts, but the words that give it can have mistakes. Or they would say, it's inspired in heavenly things, God, Christ, salvation, the second coming. But in the areas of science, history, earthly things, you can have mistakes, but the Bible wasn't given to be a historical document or a science document, things like this. Well, the problem is that if God can inspire the concept, concepts are carried by words. You can't hold a concept being true if the words can be errant. And in the same way, you can't hold that the Bible is true in areas you can't prove it, if it's false in areas that you can prove it. Now, the Bible is not a science book or a history book in a sense, but what it says about science and history is true. Paul and Jesus both built arguments in their day based on one word from the Scripture. It is verbally inspired. And secondly, it is plenarily or plentifully inspired. Jesus himself spoke of the creation. He spoke of Adam and Eve. He spoke of the Garden of Eden. He spoke of Sodom and Gomorrah. He spoke of the flood. He spoke of Jonah and the fish. Jesus spoke of Daniel. He spoke of Isaiah. Jesus treated the Bible as plentifully or plenarily inspired. My view is that the Bible is verbally, plenarily inspired. I never disagree with men raised from the dead. And if you'll make a note, that is a safe theological position. He happened to be there on the scene. What do I mean when I say it's inspired in the words of the original documents? The Bible does not grant inerrancy to the copyist. Now you say, does that take away from inerrancy? Well, suppose that I made a statement, and I gave it to Charles here, and I stood over Charles as he's writing down what I want him to say. And I, in a sense, inspire him, and I carry him along, and I say, write this, Charles. No, don't write that. Put the, okay, here we go. And I get him to write everything that I want in an original document. Now I say, Charles, I want you to preach it to the entire world. So what does Charles do? He preaches it, and he gets certain people to copy. Now, if Charles stood right here and gave you the original autograph of what I gave him, and I had you all copy it, do you think that you would copy perfectly what Charles gave? I'll promise you, some of you would write words twice, some of you would drop a word, some of you would misspell a word, and there would be a corruption in the copies. But I could take the copies, and by comparing them, I could get, without doubt, an inerrant picture of what he originally wrote. As a matter of fact, the more copies that I had, the more chance of errors would be in the copyist, but the more chance I would have of cross-referencing and getting a correct autograph. Well, that's the way that we have about 30,000 copies of the Hebrew and the Greek. Let me give you some figures. In those copies, there are when you get them all down without reproduction of error, you have about 10,000 places in the copies of miscopying. Of those 10,000 places, all but 400 of them can be corrected by anybody on the street. That'd be the leaving out of a word, the misspelling of a word. It's mechanical. And so out of 10,000 places of mistakes in the copies, you have only 400 that demand closer attention. Out of that 400, only 50 of them will change the meaning of the text, meaning that about 350 of those places, it may say Christ Jesus our Lord, or it may say our Lord Jesus Christ. And so it doesn't change the idea of the text either way. Only 50 places in the copies, depending on which 50-50 you go among the copies, can you get a different shade of interpretation. And none of those areas affect any area of biblical theology that is not documented elsewhere. That gives the Bible about a 98.5 degree copying accuracy. It comes out to a paragraph that's in question. It is the greatest degree of copying accuracy of any book on earth. As a matter of fact, the closest that comes to it is the Iliad. We only have 12 copies, and we have a 95% copying accuracy.